Thank God, there's one more chapter before we go on a break. Is nearly over. Haru-sensei has started a fight that has been built up since the time when the series was beginning to rise. It has been a grueling journey, but undoubtedly epic in all ways. 2020 is not only the next year, but the next decade. The battle has yet to decide the winner, but once it does, it's safe to say the series will begin anew. Shin vs. Hulkhead has been intense from the very start. I couldn't believe it has been over 3 chapters already. Going through the previous chapters once more, it was due to Ryboko's narrations, reactions from afar, and build up to the storytelling on the clash of two beliefs. It was designed to make this battle as the grandest one of them all, and rightfully so. It has been over a decade with this feud, and if it has to end here, then it must be noted to the world. Soon, it will all end. While I mentioned briefly on the status in the last chapter's review, Hulkhead on his knee is noteworthy. Not only indicates we're near at the end, but the sight of weakened martial god is striking, suspending disbelief level of shocking. Shin on the other hand is barely holding on. What I like about this scene is how he slowly recovers his stamina to keep going. He could barely speak at first, pausing his sentence many times. He looked ready to pass out in front of his comrades. That is until he recites the names that's supporting him from the afterlife. It finally hits me that Shin is next to the gateway to death, sensing the chi of the fallen. Not necessarily guarantee his death, but it does leave a morbid feeling. This type of concept exists in many other series where a character is close to death, so communicating with spirits is momentarily unlocked. Shin speaks to the dead, calling out their smells. I wasn't aware of Oki's to smell like a flower. In all seriousness, it is a kind, heartwarming moment, albeit morbid and concerning, that highlighted this battle as the send-off the spirits have been waiting for. The battle remains intense, but now for a different reason. It's at the brink of the end, with two men on their last ounce of stamina. This translates to breathtaking experience. Shin makes his recovery first, feeling the power from the afterlife, and goes for the swing to claim victory. Or so I hoped. Hulkhead recovers and instantly knocks back Shin with a powerful impact. I don't think I have ever seen the impact of that magnitude before. Maybe I have, but at a time like that, I cringe. Hulkhead speaks that acknowledge his belief is forever believed to be the righteous path, whereas Shin's holds back mankind. Shin may have the influence of many, but the chains that bind them won't allow them from moving forward. That's actually not a bad argument from a selfish point of view. Who to say a person would develop if they rely on their comrades to do all the motivational push? I do like Hulkhead's roar cry, forever claiming as the Bushin. That said, he's not right, and even Ryboko called him out on his flawed argument. Luckily for him, Hulkhead doesn't have powerful ears to listen from far distance. Well, to my knowledge at least. Joking aside, Ryboko makes a valid point that practically certified Hulkhead's character altogether. If he is the martial god as he claimed to be, why he couldn't defeat a human known as Oki? True, it can be argued that it was like the battle of two gods. But the point is made when recalling back when Kozen, an old man, stabbed him. I was waiting for that scene to be brought back, but now it made perfectly sense. I can understand some fans not wanting Ryboko to narrate and halt the battle, which it does happen, but I don't mind. It doesn't happen during a heated moment, often it happens when things are mostly quiet, leaving room to breathe. Also, reading in a bulk does make it easier and more appreciative on a narrative. That all said, his narration reaches to the big revelation that speaks heavily for Hawkins' character. The series has taught us to buy into the nature of a god roaming around from the beginning. Hawken has been presented as abnormal, frightening being, but it was never true. The truth is, he never transcended mankind, always forever be a human. This moment made him a man. Have I reviewed the chapter in a weekly basis from the very start, I would have been calling him a god or martial god throughout. Yes, Oki came close to defeating him, but he's one in a million rarity that can oppose a god, so to say. With Shin standing equally, the visual changed drastically, especially Hawken's glaive, now presented as a simple weapon. Sure, it's strong as hell, but no longer presented as a titan-sized destroyer. Kayane tears in the left eye again. I saw it with two meanings. One is whatever it means whenever sadness connects to Hawken. The other is the thought of defeat coming to reality. I know I'm looking into it deeply, but the timing is pretty fitting. He is their trump card. If he lose, Zhao lose. Although he can't be defeated, Shin won't be the winner, according to Ribako. I hope that means the opposite now that he has spoken. I'm amazed how the two are able to pull multiple strikes in their condition, more so with Shin. But that wouldn't last long as Hawken once again strikes him devastatingly. Shin's ear begins to bleed and his eyes are fading out. I know he's the protagonist, but I couldn't help but cringe and gasping for possible death. Even so, he still fights back. It's unbelievable. But everything dies out once he collapses. He's fighting unconsciously. This is perhaps the first time to see Shin fighting at the brink of death. He's barely holding on, but his spirit keeps him moving forward. It's painful at this point. Kyokai wakes up, but looks terrified at Shin's condition while reaching with her hand. The sensation is morbid as hell. I don't know what to think of it. Ten senses a strange aura that tells her to go to Shin now. I want to believe it's time to watch him claim victory, but it can also be time to watch him die. Ribako dropped the revelation on Hawken's character as the walking contradiction with a denial of his belief to be flawed. Now, he drops another, this time with Shin. He may have received spiritual powers from the Fallen, but he is still human. In other words, Shonen concept with realistic limitation. The chapter ends with Hawken resumed the behemoth stature, ready to end this for good. Thank God this cliffhanger isn't before the holidays break. Otherwise, I'll flip out. This was yet another great chapter with intense action with two men on the brink of defeat. When you read it in bulk, it goes by pretty smoothly. If anything, you can cut off the narration and reaction to see how it flow, for better or worse. But I'm loving every part of it. Shin has come so far. Couldn't be any prouder to be his fan. I don't know how this will end. This is all on luck now. Let the new year and decade begin with a hopeful journey. And that will do it for the review. I hope you enjoyed this one. I apologize for the lateness. On the bright side, the next chapter is around the corner. And if anything, perhaps the Christmas gift will be very special. Like Hawken's defeat. That will be amazing. What do you think of this chapter? Share your thoughts in the comment section. If you like this and want more of this, subscribe to my channel and my world will be yours to stay. Until next time, take care.